Bill Gates, a world-renowned individual known for founding Microsoft as well as his own foundation that has done tremendous good managing global disease, poverty, and education. Having worked in Silicon Valley for 5 years, I got to know and understand its culture. Folks are idealistic, wanting to change the world for the better, having a passion and firm belief that technology can make our lives better. But Silicon Valley types often extend their passions and belief beyond technology and into controversial political and social issues. Bill Gates recently donated $1 million to a Washington state referendum on background checks called I-594. He joins his billionaire buddy Michael Bloomberg and other rich techies like Steve Ballmer and Paul Allen in an attempt to purchase and throw away our freedom. At the crux of I-594, an expansion of background checks, which also restricts transfers and sales, is the lack of support from Washington state law enforcement. The primary law enforcement group opposing I-594 is the Washington State Law Enforcement Firearms Instructors Association. Here's a choice quote from their executive director, Phil Shave, addressing his members. Law enforcement officers, experienced at reading, interpreting, and applying laws, can read the text of I-594 and understand how it will affect them directly and how irrelevant it is to crime control. What you will find is a law that will be impossible to police, intended to criminalize only good citizens, a costly misdirection of scarce LE resources and funds, and a statute so broadly written that many of your own activities will become crimes. To highlight a real-life situation affected by I-594, let's say you're a law-abiding citizen living in Washington State. You want to loan a gun to one of your buddies so he or she can go shoot it at the range. If I-594 passes, that simple transfer would require a full background check by a gun dealer, and then you'd have to pay transfer fees going both ways, one fee when you receive the gun, and a second fee when you return it hours later. Not only is this a huge burden, but how are rangers going to confirm the gun's owner? Are we going to have to start carrying our papers and present them upon request? Simply unenforceable. I-594 would turn regular citizens into criminals. Not only that, the expanded background check piece creates a state database, which naturally leads to confiscation concerns. Three major Washington state law enforcement groups representing 7,500 police and sheriff's deputies are telling us that I-594 is a terrible, poorly written law. Just like Bloomberg's failed Mayors Against Illegal Guns, reincarnated into every town for gun safety, I have a feeling Bloomberg pulled the wool over Bill's eyes to make him think that I-594 is all about gun safety, when in fact, we know Bloomberg's true agenda is to confiscate and restrict all guns, exempting, of course, the rich and their personal armed bodyguards. So who are you going to listen to? A bunch of billionaires or the state's law enforcement who knows what they're talking about? Stand for something or fall for anything.